Hey, Rhonda Rosand here of New Business Directions. I'm a CPA and Advanced Certified QuickBooks Pro Advisor, and I have a short video for you today on the chart of accounts in QuickBooks. QuickBooks is made up of lists, and the most important list in QuickBooks is the chart of accounts. It is the foundation, it is the infrastructure of everything that is built for you in QuickBooks. It creates the framework for your financial reports, from your balance sheet to your income statement, which is also your profit and loss statement, and your statement of cash flows. It also creates the infrastructure for your budgets or your revenue plan. All of this is super important and needs to be simple. I believe in a one-page balance sheet and a two-page profit and loss. You don't need to sell anybody on more accounts is better. It's easier just to make it short and sweet and simple so that you can make sound financial decisions from the information that's in there. So let's talk about the different accounts in QuickBooks. There are 15 different types of accounts in QuickBooks, and they are in three main categories: the assets, the liabilities and equity, and the revenue and expenses. Your balance sheet is made up of your asset accounts, your liability accounts, and your equity accounts. Your profit and loss report is made up of revenue and expense accounts. The very first type of account you need to create in QuickBooks is a bank account. And this could be a checking account, a savings account, a money market account. It could be petty cash, drawer cash, or a barter account. All of these are bank type accounts in QuickBooks. The second type of account in QuickBooks is accounts receivable. That is monies due to you from people who you sell services to who pay you later. That is money due to you. It's an accounts receivable. The third type of an account in the asset section in QuickBooks is an other current asset. Current means less than 1 year, less than one operating cycle. It's inventory, a security deposit that you have paid to your landlord. It is prepaid expenses or expenses that you've paid in advance for things like insurance. Then we have other assets, which are your long-term assets, like a note receivable if you sold something on an installment method and it's going to be paid over time more than 1 year. Then we have fixed assets. Well, that's simply depreciable assets. It's furniture, equipment, computers, vehicles that have a useful life of more than 1 year. Then we have the payable section, the liability section. The first account is the accounts payable, and this is open bills to vendors, people you owe money to. This is an accounts payable. Then we have credit cards, very simple, credit cards. Then other current liabilities, again, less than 1 year, sales taxes, meals taxes, a line of credit that's a demand note, payroll liabilities, and then long-term liabilities. Long-term liabilities, more than 1 year. If you buy a truck, it's a fixed asset. If you have a loan on it, which you probably do, it's probably a long-term liability because it's going to take you 3, 4, 5 years to pay that off. And then we have equity accounts. And equity accounts are simply the difference between your assets and your liabilities. What you have less what you owe is your net worth or your equity. And equity accounts could be owner draw or retained earnings or investment in your company. Then we pop over to the profit and loss accounts, which are number one, income. That's what makes the money come in, that makes the math work so that the money can go out. Those are your income accounts. Cost of goods sold. A lot of people struggle with this concept, but it's really quite simple. Cost of goods sold are direct expenses related to the production of income. If you are a grocery store and you sell a can of soup, that is a cost of good when you buy it from your supplier, and it is an income when you sell it to your customer. If you're a contractor, your cost of goods are things like job materials, subcontract labor, payroll directly attributable to the construction process, equipment rental, things like that. Those are cost of goods. They're different than regular operating expenses, which is your next category. These expenses are things like advertising, dues and subscriptions, meals and entertainment, insurance, rent, heat, lights, You get the idea. Those are operational expenses. Then we have other income. Other income is interest income on bank balances, finance charges assessed to customers who don't pay you on time. Things like that are other income. And then we have other expense. And other expense are things like interest expense on loans, depreciation on assets. Those are your 15 basic types of accounts in QuickBooks, in the general categories. That's how simple it is. If you have questions about QuickBooks or need assistance, please start with our website at newbusinessdirections.com. If you need help organizing your chaos and streamlining the process, give us a call. It's okay. We're here to help.